condition. A high-level task force was constituted under the chairmanship of Principal Secretary to the PM for the management of air pollution in Delhi and NCR in November 17. The high-level task force closely monitors the implementation of measures related to management of air pollution in Delhi and NCR. Further regular review meetings have held with all concerned central government ministries, state governments under chairmanship of Honorable Minister, that is, I have conducted it, and Harshvardhan ji earlier, as well as Secretary EFCC, to ensure that various measures of prevention, control and abatement of air pollution in Delhi and NCR are taken in coordinated and effective manner. A comprehensive air plan for Delhi NCR has been developed, identifying the timelines and implementing agencies for actions delineated. The central government has notified a graded response action plan for Delhi and NCR for different levels of pollution. The nature, scope, rigor of measures to be taken is linked with the levels of pollution, namely severe plus or emergency. Severe, very poor, moderate to poor, and moderate. After due consideration by the authorities concerned, the actions are to be implemented in the entire NCR throughout the year. For management of air pollution in Delhi and NCR, source-based approach has been adopted by the government to control air pollution, which gets aggravated during winter months. Major sources contributing air pollution are industry, vehicles, road and soil dust, construction and demolition, biomass and garbage burning, etc. As per continuous ambient quality monitoring stations data, there is general improvement in air quality of Delhi in last 3 years. The good and satisfactory or moderate days, which were 106 in 2016, have improved to 152, now to 159, and I am happy to tell that out of 324 days of this year, 175 days are in this category. And the bad air days have gone down from 246 to 213 to 206 to this year's 190 days out of 324. So, this is very important. Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has launched National Clean Air Program in January 29 to tackle the problem of air pollution in comprehensive manner, with targets to achieve 20-30% reduction in PM10 and PM2.5 concentrations by 2024, keeping 2017 as the base. The plan includes 102 non-attainment cities across 23 states and union territories on the basis of their ambient air quality data between 2011 and 2015. Non-attainment cities are those which have been consistently showing poorer air quality than the national ambient air quality. Various committees have been constituted at center, steering committee headed by secretary, a joint secretary, an implementation committee under member secretary CPCB. The states have further directed to consider these committees at state level also. To help the states, UTs implement the action plans, this ministry is collaborating under a national clean air program with state pollution control boards and leading academic institutions in the state for which MOUs have been signed. The ministry has designated IIT Kanpur as the nodal academic institution to coordinate with all other IITs and other leading universities. Ministry has allocated 10 crore each for 28 cities, that is 280 crores, for million plus populations, for public awareness, capacity building, source apportionment study, mechanical street sweeper, water sprinklers, mobile enforcement units. This is important because acknowledging the problem is the beginning of solution of the problem. And therefore, tree plantation, greening activities, and many other activities with the state and city funds also. The construction and demolition waste management facility. For the remaining non-attainment cities, fund of 10 lakh per city for cities with population less than 5 lakh and 20 lakh for cities between 5 and 10 lakh is also given. So that is 172 crores. A number of initiatives have been taken.